morning, dear students. Today we are going to learn the last lesson of your book First Flight. The name of the lesson is The Proposal. The lesson is written by Anton Chekhov. Before starting the lesson, let us know about Anton Chekhov. Anton Chekhov was born on 29th January 1860 in a village in southern Russia. He was a great playwright and a short story writer. He is considered to be the greatest writers of short fiction in history. This great playwright died on 15th July 1904 at the age of 44. Now let us see the heading of this lesson, The Proposal. There are different meanings of the word proposal, such as plan, suggestion, scheme, and also the act of asking someone his hand in marriage. So what do you think? What are we going to talk about, or what is the meaning of the word proposal in this lesson? Yes, obviously the meaning is the act of asking someone's hand in marriage. Now this lesson, that is the proposal, originally it was titled as A Marriage Proposal. So it is a dramatic work which is written by a Russian writer, Anton Chekhov. It was written in the year 1888-89. This play is about the tendencies of the wealthy families of Russia to seek ties with other wealthy families. In this play, Anton Chekhov displays how the rich want to marry their children in other wealthy families. Their aim is to enhance their wealth. Now the characters in this play are quarrelsome. They keep on quarreling all the time. Still, they remember marriage proposals which will bestow monetary gains and finalize the wedding amidst the fighting. So let me talk about the characters in this play. There are three characters. The first character is Stepan Stepanovich Chuboko. He is very kind and polite. For instance, to his neighbor, he is nearly 65 years old. He is a landowner. The second character is Natalia Stepanovna. Natalia is a daughter of Chuboko. She is 25 years old. She is a fussy girl. She wants to get everything she desires. She is like a lovesick cat. The third character is Ivan Vasilevich Lumo. Ivan is a neighbor of Chuboko. He is 35 years old, which is a very critical age for getting married. He often gets nervous. His heart palpitates awfully. He is not brave in front of women. So these are the characters. Talking about the setting, the place is Chubuko's house, especially the drawing room, and the time is evening, nearly about 7 p.m. Okay, now let's get started with the lesson. Chubuko, my dear fellow, whom do I see? Ivan Vasilevich? I am extremely glad. Squeezes his hand. Now this is a surprise, my darling. How are you? Chubuko welcomes Ivan, who is his neighbor, very politely and inquires about his well-being. Chubuko shakes his hand with Ivan, and while shaking hand, he also asks him the reason for his visit. Lumo, thank you, and how may you be getting on? So Lumo thanks him for inquiring about his well-being, and he asks Chubuko about his condition, about his health. Chubuko, we just get along somehow, my angel, thanks to your prayers and so on. Sit down, please do. Now, you know, you shouldn't forget all about your neighbors, my darling. My dear fellow, why are you so formal in your getup? Evening dress, gloves and so on. Can you be going anywhere, my treasure? Now when Lumo inquires Chubuko about his condition, Chubuko replies that somehow they manage to survive peacefully with the blessings of people like Lumo himself. Then he asks him to sit down and be comfortable. Now as Lumo is in a formal getup, Chubuko is surprised and he asks whether he is going for any occasion. I was wearing a type of attire. Now Chubuko speaks very politely. So he calls him my angel, my darling, my treasure, etc. Lumo, no, I have come only to see you, honored Stepan Stepanovich. Lumo replies by saying that he is not going to any occasion. He has just come to visit Stepan Stepanovich Chubuko. Chubuko, then why are you in evening dress, my precious? As if you are paying a New Year's Eve visit. So when Lumo replies that he is not going to any occasion, Chubuko curiously asks him the reason for wearing formal clothes. To him it seems that he is paying them a New Year Eve's visit. No. Well, you see, it's like this. Takes his arm. I have come to you, honored Stepan Stepanovich, to trouble you with a request. Not once or twice have I already had the privilege of applying to you for help. And you have always, so to speak, I must ask you pardon. I am getting excited. I shall drink some water, honored Stepan Stepanovich. Respectfully, Lumo holds the arms of Chubuko and replies that he has come with the intention of troubling him with a request. He had some sort of request, and with that request he has come to visit Chubuko So here he also feels grateful. Lomo shows gratitudes to Chubuko by mentioning the time whenever he has helped him, and he continues talking. So as he continues talking, he gets very excited, and so to calm himself, he drinks water. Chubuko, aside, he has come to borrow money. Shan't give him any aloud. What is it, my beauty? Now, shan't means shall not. Okay. Chubuko makes assumptions that why Lomo has visited him. He assumes that he had come for asking money. But Chubuko doesn't have any intention of giving money to Lomo. And then he asks him why he has come there. He asks the matter of concern to Lomo. Lomo, you see, honored Stepanich, I beg pardon, Stepan Honorate. I mean, I'm awfully excited, as you will please notice. In short, you alone can help me, though I don't deserve it, of course, and haven't any right to count on your assistance. Now here, pardon means forgive or excuse, and awfully means extremely or very. Assistance, the action of helping someone. Now Lomo is very much excited, and in his excitement he is unable to speak properly. He is so excited that he could not say Chubuko's name properly, and as he is not able to call his name properly, he pardons. He asks forgiveness for this. Then he tells, Lomo tells Chubuko that he is the only person who can help him out, because any other person cannot help him in that matter. He also says that even he doesn't deserve, but he wants the help from Chubuko. Next, Chubuko, oh, don't you go round and round it, darling. Spit it out. Well, spit it out means speak out. Now, Chubuko did not understand what Lomo wanted to ask. He told Lomo to speak directly. Lomo, one moment, this very minute. The fact is, I have come to ask the hand of your daughter, Natalia Stepanovna, in marriage. Now, to seek a hand of a girl in marriage means to propose. Now, Lomo finally tells Chubuko that he had come to ask for his daughter's hand in marriage. Means that he wanted to marry Chubuko's daughter, Natalia. Chubuko, joyfully. By Jove, Ivan Vasilevich, say it again. I didn't hear it all. So when Lomo says that he wants to marry Natalia, Chubuko becomes very happy. By Jove means by God. He doesn't believe whatever Lomo has said, and he is very delighted, and so he asks him to repeat it again. Lomo, I have the honor to ask interrupting, "My dear fellow, I'm so glad and so on." "Yes, indeed, and all the sort of thing." Embraces and kisses Lomo. "I have been hoping for it for a long time. It has been my continual desire." Sheds a tear. "And I have always loved you, my angel, as if you were my own son. May God give you both his help and his love and so on, and so much hope. What am I behaving in this idiotic way for? I am off my balance with joy, absolutely off my balance. Oh, with all my soul, I'll go and call Natasha and all that." Now, when Chubuko asks him to repeat whatever he had said, Lomo continues to speak. He continues to repeat his words. So at that time, Chubuko interrupts in middle. So Chubuko is very excited, he's very cheerful. He expresses his excitement, his cheerfulness. He's so excited that his desire is getting fulfilled. He also desired that Lomo should marry his daughter Natalia. So now, as Lomo has asked Natalia's hand in marriage, Chubuko is very excited because his desire is going to be fulfilled. So in excitement, he kissed Lomo. So he couldn't control his feelings and he sheds tears. Now see, whenever somebody is very happy, tears comes out of the eyes, tears of happiness, isn't it? So he's so happy that he sheds a tear. Then he offered his blessings to both Lomo and Natalia, and then he realizes that he is behaving in an idiotic way. Idiotic means silly. So he is behaving in a silly way. Then he calls Natalia to give this great news to her. Lomo, greatly moved, honored Stepan Stepanovich, "Do you think I may count on her consent?" Consent means agreement to do something. So now Lomo asks Chubuko whether Natalia will agree his proposal, whether she would be ready to get married with him. Chubuko, "Why, of course, my darling, and as if she won't consent. She is in love, egad, she is like a lovesick cat, and so on. Shan't be long." Egad, egad means exclamation. Lovesick means a longing or desiring something. So Chubuko says that there is no way why Natalia would deny his proposal, why she would not give her consent for the proposal, because she was also longing for love. She was also in love with Lomo. Then he exits, he goes and calls Natalia, his daughter. He gives both of them chance to talk privately. Lomo, "It's cold. I'm trembling all over, just as if I had got an examination before me. The great thing is, I must have my mind made up. If I give myself time to think, to hesitate, to talk a lot, to look for an ideal or for real love, then I'll never get married. It's cold." Natalia Stepanovna is an excellent housekeeper, not bad looking, well educated. What more do I want? But I'm getting a noise in my ears from excitement. Drills, and it's impossible for me not to marry. In the first place, I'm already 35, a critical age, so to speak. In the second place, I ought to lead a quiet and regular life. I suffer from palpitations. I am excitable and always getting awfully upset. At this very moment, my lips are trembling and there is a twitch in my right eyebrow. But the very worst of all is the way I sleep. I no sooner get into bed and begin to go off when suddenly something in my left side gives a pull and I can feel it in my shoulder and head. I jump up like a lunatic, walk about a bit and lie down again. But as soon as I begin to get off to sleep, there's another pull. And this may happen 20 times. Trembling means shaking, quivering. Hesitate means take a pause while speaking something or while doing something. Housekeeper, a person who manages or takes care of a house. Palpitations means a rapid, strong, irregular heartbeat due to excitement, anxiety, or due to illness. Twitch, a sudden quick movement. Lunatic means a person who is mentally ill. Now let us see the explanation of this para. So now Lumo was very nervous. As he asked Natalia's hand in marriage. So he became very nervous. He trembles, shakes, as if he is appearing for an examination. So whenever you appear for examination, you feel nervous, isn't it? So similarly, Lumo felt nervous. He was shaking as if he was appearing for examination. So he feels it great that he had already made up his mind for getting married. Because he feels that if he gives time to think about it, to ponder about it, his marriage would end up getting delayed or maybe probably cancelled. He assures himself that Natalia would make a great partner for him because she was average looking. She was a good housekeeper. Housekeeper? A person who manages household. So, she would manage the household properly. Then also she was well educated. So she had all these qualities. What else does a man need? Isn't it? So, Lumo thought that she would be a perfect partner for him. He was still excited and he could feel some noises in his ears. There was no option than to marry because he was 35 years old, which is a very critical age for getting married. So he thought that if he would delay now, he would not get married later on. He wanted to live a normal life. Generally, he suffers from palpitation. His heartbeats are, the rate of his heartbeat becomes high. It becomes abnormal. also he becomes upset easily. Even at that moment, his lips were trembling, eyebrows twitching. Above all this, he was also not able to get sound sleep at night. He used to feel a pull in his, on the right side of his head and shoulder. Then he jumps, he walks, he lies down. But as soon as he tries to sleep again, he feels another pull. So this goes on almost for 20 times. 20 times he feels a pull on the right side of his head and shoulder. Natalia, well, there, it's you. And Papa said, go, there is a merchant come for his goods. How do you do, Ivan Vasilevich? Now Chubuko's daughter, Natalia, she enters the drawing room and she's surprised to see Ivan Vasilevich. Her father had told that some merchant had come to sell his goods. She also inquires Lumu about his health. Lumu, how do you do, honored Natalia Stepanovna? Natalia, you must excuse my apron and negligee. We are shelling peas for drying. Why haven't you been here for such a long time? Sit down. They seat themselves. Won't you have some lunch? So now when Natalia enters, Lomo also inquires Natalia about her well-being. Negligee means a form of nightgown. Natalia apologized for her apron and dress as they had been shelling peas for drying, and she asks him to be comfortable. She also offers him lunch. Lumo, no thank you, I have had some already. Natalia, then smoke. There are the matches. The weather is splendid now, but yesterday it was so wet that the workmen didn't do anything all day. How much hay have you stacked? Just think, I felt greedy and had a whole field cut. And now I am not at all pleased about it because I am afraid my hay may rot. I ought to have waited a bit. But what's this? Why you are in evening dress? Well, I never. Are you going to a ball or what? Though I must say you look better. Tell me, why are you got up like that? Now, Natalia offers him lunch, he thanks her and says that he already had lunch. Then she offers Lumo to smoke. Then she talks about the weather they were experiencing that day. The weather was very good and how bad it was the previous day. That day weather was very good, but previous day the weather was very bad. So the weather was so bad that the workmen couldn't do anything the whole day. The entire day they couldn't work at all. She starts talking about the haystack. She also tells that how greedy enough she had been that she cut the entire field. And now she was worried about it. She feels that the hay may rot. Now while talking, suddenly she notices his attire and asks him if he was going for a ball. Ball means a party. She also gives him the compliment and asks him for the occasion. Lumo, excited. You see, honored Natalia Stepanovna, the fact is I have made up my mind to ask you to hear me out. Of course, you will be surprised and perhaps even angry, but it's awfully cold. Natalia, what's the matter? Well, I shall try to be brief. You must know, honored Natalia Stepanovna, that I have long since my childhood, in fact, had the privilege of knowing your family. My late aunt and her husband, from whom, as you know, I inherited my land, always had the greatest respect for your father and your late mother. The Lumos and the Chubukos have always had the most friendly and I might almost say the most affectionate regard for each other. And as you know, my land is a near neighbor of yours. You will remember that my oxen meadows touch your birch woods. So now Lumo begins to talk and tells her that she would be surprised or even angry on hearing him. While speaking, he feels very cold. So Natalia asks him the matter of concern, what the matter was. Now Lumo tries to tell her in brief. He starts talking about the good relation between both the families. His late aunt and her husband respected Natalia's family. He even tells that their lands are neighbors to each other and his oxen meadows touches his birch woods. Natalia, excuse my interrupting you. You say my oxen meadows, but are they yours? Lumo, yes, mine. Natalia, what are you talking about? Oxen meadows are ours, not yours. Lumo, no, mine, honored Natalia Stepanovna. Natalia, well, I never knew that before. How do you make that out? Lumo, how? I am speaking of those oxen meadows which are wedged in between your birch woods and the burnt marsh. Natalia, yes, yes, they are ours. Lumo, no, you are mistaken, honored Natalia Stepanovna. They are mine. Natalia, just think, Ivan Vasilevich, how long have they been yours? Lumo, how long? As long as I can remember. Natalia, really? You won't get me to believe that. Now Natalia interrupts in the middle when he talks about the oxen meadows. And she asks him whether the oxen meadows, which he claims to be his, are actually his. So Lumo affirms. He gives answer in affirmation. He says yes, that the oxen meadows belong to him. So now Natalia couldn't believe what she was hearing, because according to her, the oxen meadows were hers. The Lumo claims that the oxen meadows were his. So Natalia asks that, tells that she had never known it before, and she asked Lumo how he had found out that those oxen meadows were his. Then Lumo tries to give an explanation. He points out the exact oxen meadows which which he is talking about. The ones that are wedged between birch woods and the burnt marsh. So he mentions exactly that he was talking about the oxen meadows which were between the birch woods and burnt marsh. So Natalia says that yes, I am also talking about the same oxen meadows, and that oxen meadows belong to her. So now Lubo thinks that there is some misunderstanding that Natalia has, because he is very sure that the oxen meadows belong to him. So now Natalia tells Lumo to think that for how long that oxen meadows belonged to him. So Lumo replies that they have been his forever. Now Natalia replies that she could not believe him. So that's it for today. I hope you have understood. We'll see the next part of this lesson in our next class. Till then, thank you.